Final Cut Pro 11 is finally here, and one of the headlining features is Transcribe to Captions. Transcribe to Captions allows you to generate captions using Apple Intelligence in a matter of seconds for your entire video. Think of this as a 1.0 release for this particular feature, which unfortunately means at this time, it's only available in English. However, I'm really hoping we get to see more languages in the near future, as well as maybe some translation features so that our videos can reach even more people. A few things to consider: you do need macOS Sequoia to access this feature, as well as an Apple Silicon Mac. To transcribe your audio, it's super easy. I have this timeline that is 4 minutes and 20 seconds, which you can keep in mind just to see how fast this transcription process is. To transcribe it, we're just going to select all of the video clips I would like to transcribe. From there, I'm going to go up to the magic wand. Clicking here, we can see this new option for Transcribe to Captions. Now, the very first time you click this button, you will be downloading a transcription model from Apple. That said, once you've downloaded this model, you won't have to download it again anytime soon. Once it's downloaded the model, you'll see that it is transcribing to captions, and you can see just how fast it is at processing this particular video. Again, this entire video is 4 minutes and 20 seconds, and it's already completed through the transcription process. Now, the first thing you might notice is all of the transcriptions happening here at the top of the timeline. You'll also notice that they are showing up here directly inside of the viewer. These are going to be enabled by default once you've transcribed your audio. If you ever need to disable your transcriptions once you've generated them, you can simply come on over to the index on the left-hand side, make sure you're in the roles tab, and you'll see your captions here at the top. From there, we can disable the captions so that they are no longer visible. The next thing you might have noticed are these red captions happening in the timeline. This is because I have two captions that are slightly overlapping each other. This can be caused by many different things, but it's extremely easy to resolve. If you need to resolve this, all we need to do is select one of the red ones and then push Command A to select all of our captions. Then we can go up to Edit, go down to Captions, and then we'll select Resolve Overlaps. Once we've done that, we can see that Final Cut Pro has automatically gone in and trimmed up those captions, fixing any of those overlapping issues. Another thing you might notice is I have all of my captions selected, and I can go ahead and make formatting changes to all of the captions at once over here on the right hand side. So for example, if we wanted to make them all bold, maybe underlined, and even change the color, we could do so right from this screen. That said, you should know that not all platforms support these changes, so your captions might look different on some platforms. I'm going to undo all those changes using Command Z. And another thing you should be aware of is you can change where each individual caption is placed. Right now they're at the bottom by default, but if we ever wanted to, we could either select an individual caption or all of our captions and change the placement up to the top. Now, if you ever need to edit the text on a specific caption, you can go ahead and select that caption. And then over here in the right side, we can make changes just like any other title. So for this, we can see that Final Cut Pro was not properly capitalized. Let's go ahead and adjust for that. Now that I'm happy with my captions, it's time to export them, and this is super easy to do. Clicking inside of your timeline, go on up to the top left, select File, and then select Export Captions. You can rename the captions to whatever you like, you can choose where to export them to, and you can choose which captions to export. So if you have any other languages, you could select those here. Additionally, we can choose the start time on these captions. By default, it's going to be relative to timeline, which is typically what you're gonna wanna do. From there, we can push export. Captions export almost instantaneously, and now we can find that file here on the desktop. And from there, we could upload it to something like YouTube or even Vimeo. Another option for exporting captions is that it can be done at the same time of exporting your main video. To do so, just go on up to File, go down to Share, and select Export File, or you can get that with Command E. From there, we can jump on over into the Roles tab, and you'll notice that our captions are here at the bottom. We can go ahead and select this checkbox next to export each ITT language as a separate file if you want to. But if you want these captions to be burned into your video, you can also do that by clicking on this blue icon that says captions. Then coming down to the bottom, you'll see burn in captions and change this over to English or whatever caption you want to export. From there, we'll push OK, and we can now go through the full export process. Now, I know you likely have the first question that I had when I saw this feature, and that is, can we export these captions as titles for Final Cut Pro. Unfortunately, it's not directly in Final Cut Pro at this time, but there's also a really great free alternative for those of you that might be interested. The free alternative can be found at editingtools.io. I'm not affiliated or sponsored by them, but what we can do is go to Converters, go down to Subtitle Tool and Converter, and from there we can browse our files, locate the caption we want to use. It will automatically update the format to what we need, and now we can convert it to whatever format we like. And in this instance, we'll want it to be Apple Final Cut Pro subtitles as titles. Then from there, we can change the frame rate to whatever your project's frame rate is and push generate. Once it's done, we can download it, save it to wherever we like. And when you're ready to bring it into Final Cut Pro, locate the file, double click on it, select the project that you want to import to, and now we'll have all of those captions as title directly in Final Cut Pro. You might need to do some fine tuning for the titles that go off of the screen, but if you want to, you can change stuff like the font and placement on all of these at the same time. To do so, just select them all. We'll go into our font and change it over to something like Roboto. We could make it bold. You could change the size on all of them. And if you wanted to change the position on all of these, you'll need to use your transform tool. Don't try and use the position tool here in the titles. Make sure you're using the transform tool. To do so, we'll get our transform tool in the bottom left. And now I can just drag this down to the bottom of the screen and push done. So if we take a look at all of these titles, you'll see they're at the bottom of the screen. From there, with all of them selected, we can push Command C and then jump over to the project that we want to bring them into and push Command V to paste them. So now we'll have all of those titles appearing here at the bottom in the same way that we just changed them to. If this video was helpful to you, then you might be interested in sticking around with the subscription as I have way more Final Cut Pro 11 tutorials coming out very, very soon. Also, you might be interested in checking out this video where I do a broad overview of all of the new features that came to Final Cut Pro 11. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and with that being said, I cannot wait to see you in the next one.